Hi, I'm DC Breaks, welcome to the channel. In this video, I'm going to be exploring how you can use a free suite of AI composition tools called Magenta Studio in Ableton Live to generate and manipulate and develop MIDI clips. So let's jump on in. So there's two ways that you can use Magenta Studio. One is as a standalone app, and the other is as a Max for Live device within Ableton Live. And that's really where it kind of comes into its own. It's a really straightforward interface. There's just these five buttons. Each of these opens up a different module, and they all use AI in slightly different ways to either generate or manipulate MIDI clips within Live. So this is a great tool, a suite of tools for getting creative and generating some MIDI data that we can use as a kind of jumping off point for starting new ideas when we're working in Live, or indeed for developing our own ideas as well. So we'll take a look at these, and we'll start with the generate module, which, as you might expect, allows us to generate some MIDI content, which can either be drums or melodies. You simply choose the track that you want to use. I'm going to use the drum rack on one here. Choose where you want the clip to go, how many variations, so how many clips we're going to generate, in this case 8. And then you have this temperature control, which allows us to set the complexity of the generated material. So lower temperatures tend to yield simpler results, and higher temperatures tend to yield more complex results. So we'll just leave that somewhere in the middle and hit generate. And it's worth mentioning, as we now dive into these, that this is based on millions of different songs that's been used as the training data for this AI. So there should be some kind of coherence to this. It's not just spitting out randomly generated data. So let's take a look and listen to some of these and see if they're any good. Okay, so I didn't really like that long cymbal note in there for that part, but this first part was absolutely fine. We can listen to some of the other variations as well. Okay, that's a very simple one. Okay, so you get the general idea, but without previewing every single one, I think that first one that we listened to there, number 4, was half decent. Okay, let's just rename that. Let's call it something imaginative like beat. And so we can use the same technique to generate a melody for a synth that I have loaded up into this slot here. So once again, exactly the same. Let's see what it does. Okay, so again, it's not going to write the whole tune for you. It's really about generating MIDI content that you can kind of almost curate and use as a starting point for, you know, making your own ideas. So what I'm going to do is just go back in and edit that. Oops, just deleted the wrong part there. Sorry, my mouse is playing up. Here we go. Which one is it? That was the one that we want. So just get rid of that one. And these ones, and I was also going to get rid of all of this stuff here as well. So now we have the basis of an idea. Okay, let's do the same thing again now with generate, and this time just generate another lead part over here. We'll make this slightly more complex in the hope that we get something a bit more melodic that will kind of serve as a counterpoint or a juxtaposition for the sort of baseline idea we've got there. A as you can hear, it sounds quite out of tune. So another good idea is to use the scaler to keep any clips that you're generating within the same key. So let's try that now. Okay, so it's not perfect by any means, and what it's not doing in this case is to, you know, look at what's going on here and use that to kind of shape this. So whilst they're in the same key now, they're not necessarily going to be working harmonically at all times. And so some points it sounds good and other points it doesn't sound good. But there are ways to fix that using other tools within the suite. But before we do that, let's look at the groove module. And the groove module, as the name suggests, is a way to add groove to, I guess it's really anything, but it's designed with drums in mind because it's been trained on a vast data set of drummers, human drummers. So the way this works is exactly the same. We just choose the clip that we want to do and the temperature and hit generate. It's going to stick it in the next available clip slot here below us. And if we compare the two, you'll see the first beat that we generated was really static, kind of on the groove. On the grid, and lacking in groove, and all the velocity notes are all the same at 100. And instead, now what we have is we have some of the notes kind of shifted off the grid a little bit, and there's all these different velocities. And again, because it's trained on real drummers, this is like a kind of humanized tool and should make our beat sound a bit groovier and a bit more natural. So let's take a listen and see how it now sounds. And again, it may be that we need to add back in some of the content that, you know, like this snare here, for example, could do with coming up, and probably have one there as well to kind of maintain the feel of the drums that we had. But again, it's just an idea generator, right? So you don't have to. We could modify this again further if we wanted to. Hey guys, I hope you're enjoying the content. Just to let you know that we offer online courses in a range of creative subjects. So if you're interested in taking your skills and knowledge to the next level, check out the link below. Let's now look at another module, which is the Interpolate module. So what we can do with this is take two different clips and it will generate an interpolation of, or interpolate both inputs and spit out something that's a kind of combination of those two things. So let's take our melody. We need to do this on the same track, so I actually just need to drag this one down here and then choose our two clips. We can choose the number of steps and again the temperature. Let's hit generate. And so we can see now that these clips are kind of different variations getting more complex between our simple kind of baseline idea and the much more complex melodic idea. So let's hear how the two interpolated end up kind of sounding. So it might be that if we wanted our melody to be more in keeping with the bassline that we had, we could do something like this and, you know, use this for our melody and, you know, maybe have this as our slightly evolved bassline, something like that. So this clip here and this one here. you can hear now that they are much more closely aligned in terms of musical ideas, and it's starting to sound a bit more cohesive. I appreciate it doesn't sound very good at this moment, but you can see how these tools could be used to generate some workable ideas that you can then kind of develop. But even if you can't develop them, you can use the continue module, because this takes some of the data that we've now generated and will continue it for us in a similar way. So this could either be, again, drums, if we wanted to progress our drums, or melodies. Let's try it with a melody. Let's try this piece that we've just created here, our interpolation. And again, same kind of controls, variations, length, and temperature. And now what this will do is, if we just look at our initial idea, it'll copy that initial idea here and then take it on and develop it. And so we've got some different variations here. So the starting point is exactly the same. It then just gives us a variation to follow it up with. And so this is a great tool for developing ideas, either that we've written or we've generated, to progress the composition side of our track. Let's try a different one. So that's really all of the ones from a kind of generational point of view, if you like, that is kind of using inputs, although Generate doesn't use an input. And then there's Drumify, which is again different, because the way that this works is it will take an input, usually a melodic input, and then it will create a rhythm or drum part for it based on that as an input. So if we take our new generated clip there, for example, so that's in lead 2, it's the one called 2-4, and hit generate, it'll have to overwrite this one here, which will warn me about, which is fine. It's going to generate a drum part. So we now just need to move this back over to our drums, and then we should have a drum part that kind of matches the rhythm or the feel of the melodic part. So let's hear how that sounds. So rather than generating different ideas melodically and drums completely differently and separately and hoping that they kind of fit together, we can use the rhythm of the melodic part to generate a drum part, and then hopefully they will fit together a bit more cohesively. So that's really it for the suite of tools. As you can see, it's not really AI in the sense that, oh, you just tell it what you want it to make and it goes out and just makes something for you. It's really a creative tool and quite an effective one that you can use to generate and manipulate ideas. And as I said, kind of use it as a jumping off point for coming up with new ideas to use in your projects. So that's Magenta Studio. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Personally, I think it's a really interesting addition to the rapidly growing number of AI tools that are available at the moment. It is free, so go and check it out. And if you like this video, please do like and subscribe to get more videos like this delivered straight to your inbox from us here at the DBS Institute. But that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.